Hello YouTube and welcome to another video from Tech with Stefan. Today we're going to take a closer look at the Galaxy Active Watch 2 and we have it here and we're going to compare it with the Apple Watch that we have here. So yeah, this is the box and inside you only get the watch and the charging cable which is magnetical like this. Okay, let's put aside the box here and let's take a closer look at the watch. And as you can see, this is a round face watch and it looks very, very good. Front of the display it's AMOLED and it's covered with a glass, and you get here the touch sensitive scroll wheel which is only in capacitive kind. So they used to have a mechanical one, right now it's only a touch sensitive one. And you also get very similar an Apple Watch with a crown here. Rotating the crown, it will take you zoom in, zoom out. So yeah, these are the two watches, and let's take a closer look at the hardware. And you can see this is a round face watch and this is a squared but with rounded edges. And which one looks better, it's a matter of choice. I think this one is nice because it's round and more classic look like a watch, and the Apple Watch has its own beauty, let's say. And let's take a closer look at the hardware. You have a strap here made of silicone. You can easily replace this one by unclipping here the point. And on the back you get very, very similar sensors to the one on the Apple Watch. Let's take a closer look, and we can see they both have very similar LEDs on the back, and these two metal electrodes are for measuring ECG. And of course, if we zoom in, you can see more details about how they look. But they have very similar hardware, even for measuring. Keep that in mind. And of course, they both have microphones holes here, and you can take calls on it. And they have two buttons, and of course, they have also a speaker, which is used for having calls on your watch. That's about it with the hardware. And one thing that I want to point out, it's regarding the charging cable. And here you have the magnets, which are stronger on this side, but on this side it's a bit weaker. And you will see it's not strong enough to hold the Galaxy Watch. So this is a minus point that I have to give to the Galaxy Watch. While on the Apple you get a similar cable, but this one it's a lot stronger. So the magnet here, it can easily hold the watch, as you can see here. So in my opinion, this is a better implementation than the Galaxy Active 2. Okay, let's put this aside. Let's take a closer look at the watches. And as you can see here, they have watch faces that can be changed. And of course on the Galaxy you need to press it, hold it, and then you can switch through the faces. And the Apple Watch is pretty similar, you only need to swipe and the face will change. And you can download a lot more from the App Store, but in this regard they are very, very similar. And you get here some informations even on the Apple Watch, and of course drop down menu. For both devices you can change the options. This is the back button and this is the back button here. So yeah, they are very similar in this regard, and they seem to be pretty good optimized for one hand use. So you only need one hand to scroll through the menus. And then the Apple Watch, of course, you only need
one. Of course you can install a lot more apps from the App Store, and Apple has a bigger ecosystem than the Galaxy Watch, but yeah, you can get apps from the App Store and search for them and all that stuff you get here. Also on the Apple Watch you get an App Store. So yeah, this is the difference in between them. And of course there are a lot of apps, and this is the way you scroll through the menu on the Galaxy Watch. And on the Apple Watch, you can use the scroll wheel to zoom in, zoom out. And this is how it actually looks. So both they are very, very similar. It's only a matter of choice what you like more. And of course, you can make calls from both devices and go through the keyboard and type the number that you want to call. This is the same on the Galaxy Active 2 watch. So yeah, you can make calls from both devices. And of course, there are a lot more apps. And let's take a closer look at the, let's say, activity. You can choose from a lot of workouts on both devices. And I will just choose cycling on both devices to see how it looks. And you can see how similar they are. And this is the information that you get on the screen. So basically, you get heart rate, distance, duration, average speed, and all that stuff you do get on your, and of course they need to be on your hand, on your wrist, to have precise heart rate measurements and all the other stuff. But this is how it actually looks like, and the menu is pretty simple, and of course you can press back to close and finish, and on the Apple Watch scroll and finish on both devices. And you will see the summary after you will close this exercise. Okay, that's about it with the, let's say, interfaces and the menu. And what I would like to show you more, it's about the Active Watch 2. So right now they have activated in Europe also the heart rate measurements like blood pressure and ECG. And to do this, you need to place it on your hand, and this is how you measure it. Place your finger on the button here and just stay quiet and do not move. And as you can see here, this is how it looks like, but I'm moving and the measurement will not be precise. And of course, the app does not look for heart attack. It's only looking for fibrillations and small stuff. But it's good enough to find out some fibrillation issues. And right now it's status, and you can check it on your phone. So here it is on the mobile phone, and you can see the heart rate, it's 97. And of course you can zoom in on the graphs here, and you can send this to your doctor, and he will take a closer look and tell you what's the matter with your heart. But this is not a medical device, and it's only for detecting fibrillations or stuff like that. Keep that in mind. And of course, you get the same on the Apple Watch. You need to place it on your hand. And then you go into the ECG measurement app, place your finger on the crown, and it will start measuring. Of course, you need to be silent and do not move, which I am doing right now, but you will see the results. On your Apple Watch, and then it will send it to the iPhone. And you can send it from there to the other doctor. Okay, so this is a normal measurement. And of course, you can check it on your phone. This is how it looks like, and you can see it and send this to a doctor. So yeah, this is very, very similar on both devices. And the Galaxy Watch has something that the Apple Watch does not have. And this is blood pressure measurements. And you need to first calibrate the watch with actual blood pressure measurement device. And then it will, of course, you need to stay still and this is how it looks like. But you need to first calibrate it and then it will be able to measure. And I think I need to rest my hand. Yeah, now it's done and we can see the results here. So basically this is not, let's say, a medical device, it's only for gathering some data which is based on the calibration you made before. So I will not be 100% sure of these results. They are only good for noticing small issues. Okay, so that's about it with what they can measure. And of course, they both have heart rate measurements, which is normal for any device. And we can see how it looks when you're measuring on both devices the heart rate. But yeah, keep in mind, they both have similar functions and the heart rate measurement is a bit faster on the Apple Watch, but it is good also on the Galaxy Active 2. So yeah, besides all these measurements, both watches feel very, very snappy in their app store and menus. And which one do you prefer? It depends on you. And one thing you need to know, Apple Watch works with iPhones and the Galaxy Active 2 works with Android and Apple devices. So this is a plus for the Active Watch 2, while on the Apple Watch you only get iPhones compatibility. So yeah, my overall opinion is you need to choose which one do you prefer more, the round face watch like Active 2 or the Apple Watch. And of course, you are stuck with an iPhone on this one, and on the Galaxy Active 2 you can change to Android or iPhone. So yeah, that's my opinion. Please like, share and subscribe and leave me in the comments what you like to see more. Bye bye.